Well, Shoreline Church, this is your devotional for Wednesday, June 24th. This is our first week moving to one devotional a week, and I hope you stay tuned in and these inspire you. And we're continuing on in the Psalms, and particularly the Psalms of Ascent. And Psalm 127 is just power-packed with wisdom. I invite you to listen closely to God's Word from Psalm 127. Unless the Lord builds the house, its builders labor in vain. Unless the Lord watches over the city, the guards stand watch in vain. In vain you rise early and stay up late, toiling for food to eat, for he grants sleep to those he loves. Children are a heritage from the Lord, offspring a reward from him. Like arrows in the hands of a warrior are children born in one's youth. Blessed is the man whose quiver is full of them. They will not be put to shame when they contend with their opponents in court. This is an interesting psalm because it talks about this is in vain and this is in vain and there's lots of things in vain. It's clear that you know, raising the next generation, pouring into the next generation, that's valuable. But there's lots of things that if we don't keep God in the center of our lives, we'll end up doing things with really no results, in vanity and something that's really powerless. So listen to these three pictures that are painted in this particular psalm. First, it's one about production. Unless the Lord builds the house, its builders labor in vain. You can build and build and build, but if God's not in it, ultimately it's not going to bear fruit. So in our labor, in the things we produce, bring the Lord into the middle of it. Invite God in, and it won't be in vain. It will have great meaning and purpose. Bring God into everything you do. And then the second thing, and it's still in verse 1, unless the Lord watches over the city, the guards stand watch in vain. Now it moves from production to protection. It says even if you post guards around the city, if God's not in it, you're in trouble still. Invite God to protect you, to watch over you. Let him be your mighty fortress, your tower, your protector. So understand, do post a guard, but say, God, will you be in this? Be careful, put boundaries up in your life, be wise, but ask for the power of the Spirit to guide. And then in verse 2, in vain you rise up early and stay up late, toiling for food to eat. It says it's vanity to get up super early in the morning, stay up late at night, work without God in the middle of it. And when you do have God in the middle of it, you actually find peace and you can rest. That verse ends by saying, for he grants sleep to those he loves. God gives you rest. Our God is a God of Sabbath. So yes, work hard, but keep God in the middle of it. And know that rest is a good gift. I want to pray for you that you would keep God in the middle of all your production and anywhere you need protection and then just the flow of your life, that you would find his rest. Lord, that's our prayer today. We thank you for this psalm that reminds us that we can work and work and work, but if you're not in it, it's not going to bear the fruit we want. God, you remind us that we can post a guard and try to protect ourselves and have the right security system and the right measures in place, but God, you're the one who watches over us. We cry out to you, God, protect us and watch over us and those that we love. And then, God, we can work and work and work from early morning to late at night. But God, we want you to be in it. And as we walk with you and as you're in the midst of all that we do, grant us the rest that we need. Thank you, God, for the greatness of your love and the presence of your grace in our lives. We pray this in Jesus' name and for his glory. Amen. Well, I want to encourage you as we close our time together. Would you remember to pray for our Shoreline staff and for our leadership team? Matter of fact, on our website, we have a picture of all of our staff members, all of our L team members. I'd encourage you to open that up and pray. You may not know who Thomas is, the guy who records all these videos, but he's standing right there and his picture's on the website. And you can click on that and learn about him and about his wife and their life a little bit, and then pray. Pray for each person who serves you and serves our church and serves this community and the world as a leadership team member or a staff member. God bless you. Have a great day. And we'll see you Sunday in our services, either online or on campus.